Hello guys, today we are going to sew matching pattern and we are going to use the easiest example that we can have. My customer brought me this apron that is very beautiful but it doesn't have pockets. So she bought another one exactly the same for me to use the pocket, but she wants me to match the pattern. So let's do it. I'm gonna start by marking the pocket where I need it. Of course, she marked it, but sometimes customer won't mark it exactly in the center, so we wanna have the same distance at both sides so it looks nicer. And this is the first thing that I'm marking. Then I will mark the top just to make sure that it's all straight. I'm taking the measurement from the border, and now I can remove all my masking tape. And I will mark my pocket all the way around. This will ensure that my pocket will look fantastic. This is the lower line and I am marking from the bottom border. And then I will mark the center, but the center is not so important because right now what I need is just the perimeters. Now I'm gonna put my two apron together. And what I'm doing is to see the perimeter inside. And then I will cut like a lot more material that I need because I need to leave some material for, if I made a mistake, for playing it. You know, when you match pattern, you always have to be very careful. It takes more material. Like if you need 2 meters to do a job, then you have to buy 3 or 2.75 to do exactly the same job if you want to match the patterns. So I'm cutting the oversized piece that I will use for the pocket. And my next step is to put them together. You know, if that were paper, it would have been so easy because the paper just doesn't move. But with the material, with the fiber, they really, really move, and you have to be a little bit more careful. After they match, what I'm gonna do is to mark again in my upper material what will be my pocket as it is inside. And I will use that as a guide. And at the top, of course, I am marking an extra line for folding twice for the hem on the top of the pocket. Then after I have all my lines marked, I'm gonna cut it because now I know that I can use that pocket. Then I'm going to my sewing machine and I will start by doing the top hem of the pocket. I mark it this way because the resulting job is more straight and nice. Then I will go to my ironing board and I will fold all the other corners. I have 3 sides that needs to be folded. With the corners, you can do whatever you want. If you want, you can just fold the corners straight. That's not big deal. But if you want a little bit nicer finish, you can miter the corner. Just you have to make sure to fold like a triangle at 45 degrees and you will have a very sharp corners that way. The other way, the corners are sharp too, but you can see the material underneath and that make it a little bit less clean and more difficult to work with. But you don't need to get worried about that because the difference is not substantial. It's just a tiny difference. Now I have all my pocket folded and I'm going to place it on my fabric. This step is very important because you have to check all the detail of the patterns to see that the lines will continue from the top to the bottom piece. And then you can pin them in place. And as I said before, if were paper would have been easier, but because it's material, you have to know that the fibers of the material wiggle a little bit. That's why I will go and baste all my pocket all around. This was one of the first things that I learned back when I was studying fashion design. And that have helped me so much along my career because if I do either custom made or alteration, I always try to make the pattern match. Sometimes it's not possible because of the material, but you know, whenever you can, you do it. Now I'm going to my sewing machine and I am sewing, but as you can see, I have to kind of still fix it a little bit while I'm sewing it, because this material really moves a lot and it's very hard to do it, but not impossible. It can be done. I make sure to secure the corners of my pockets, and then I will go and proceed to remove my basting. And my pocket is almost ready. I just have now to erase all the marks I did and top stitch in the center to divide the pocket in two. And let me play you a snippet of my customer reaction.
My goodness, this is a designer. You know when you buy clothes, when they when the stitches match, it like
you know that it's good. Exactly. Yeah?
You've done a fine job. I could not have asked anything better.
So guys, if you find this video useful, please give us a like. That helps us a lot. And if you haven't subscribed yet, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Bye!